Okay, over to you, Freddie. Start us off with that one. Tim, what did you think of that?
I reckon that at some point sometimes the bass peaked a bit too much and it distorted quite a bit. And in the first section, because there were so many synths in there, I kind of lost count, but in the first section one the synths could be turned up a little bit.
Okay. The initial bass sound was quite loud in the start and it was showing the same frequency region as one of the synths, and it was masking that sort of stab sound synth. So I think perhaps a bit of EQ to cut out the bottom end of the synth. But great though, I thought, you know, I mean, that's just one very small thing.
I like the drum sequence, and then especially when it went down to that synth.
Well, those little
clicky
fills and stuff.
Yeah.
Really cool.
I like that blink sound.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did you use for the drums? samples are like.
Yeah.
I really like the sort of 8-bit chiptune thing to it.
I really
like to see sort of the end where it's like a lot more simple.
Yeah, no, I think I like that, the end part more.
Yeah, because at the start it sort of sounds a bit.
Right.
It sounds good, but it sounds a bit. Yeah, that's okay. The synth thing you have right at the start though.
Yeah, the arrangement was good in the second part.
I think overall the tune for Freddie is wicked.
Absolutely, definitely.
You know, the music in there, like the combination of sounds, the melodies, the chords, everything's there. I think all it needs is a good mix down. I think you've done all the detailed work on the program and the arrangement. It might even be interesting to try opening it up next time, you know, you're working on it. Just take all the volume faders on every sound down to zero. If there's any volume automation on stuff, get rid of it and just start the mix from the top. Sometimes I think like when you're really far into working on a tune, you kind of trick yourself into thinking you have to leave that kick drum level where it is, you have to leave the snare drum where it is, where sometimes it's better to just reset it all. And I think it should be easier to kind of work out how loud you need things. So a couple of people noticed that 808 kick drum. I guess it's because you've been working on headphones as well. This is another thing you'll notice, guys, the difference between mixing down on kind of closed back headphones or your little iPod headphones. They're no substitute for sitting in, you know, a room with some speakers, you know, no matter how naff they are or how good they are, it does make a great deal of difference. And use that multimeter, okay? I know, you know, mixing down tracks isn't just about looking at levels, it's about how it sounds. But the multimeter and Logic will give you a really good indication if something is way louder than anything else. You'll just be able to see it. But overall, Freddie, look at you.